Hey everyone, welcome to Another Will I Buy It. In this video, we're gonna be chatting about all the new makeup releases. I'm gonna be telling you if I'm gonna pick them up. And I would also love to hear from you in the comments if you are interested in any of these releases. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do today. We have a lot to talk about, so let's get into this video. So if you haven't been on my channel before, my name is Marley and I love making YouTube videos about makeup and beauty. I love trying out new makeup, I love trying out new things, but I also like to keep myself a little bit in check, not buy too much. And in these videos I kind of reflect on the new releases and tell you why I want to buy something or why I don't want to buy something, and I do this every 2 weeks. I'm kind of thinking maybe doing it more often, but if that sounds good to you, then don't forget to subscribe. I usually upload about 2 to 3 videos a week and I would love to see you again on my channel. So let's get into these new releases. I'm just gonna scooch a little bit. So I feel like there have been some kind of interesting things that have been released, but I don't know if I really want to pick any of it up. Also, I kind of want to buy a bit less makeup. I feel like I've kind of let it get out of hand and I've kind of bought too many things. Maybe some things that I could have said no to and maybe could have been a little bit more patient and waited for the really exciting releases to come out. So actually I kind of want to do a little bit of a low buy, and the rule is gonna be like, can I say no to this? Can I say no to this? Can I say no to this for now? Can I maybe try this later? And if the answer is yes, I can say no to it, I don't wanna buy it. The things that I feel like I can say no to are things that I usually review on my channel, that are really brands that are part of my channel and that I feel will add a lot of value to my channel. So I'm not gonna buy things that I find fun to review but I know people don't watch it, and I'm not gonna buy things that are just for me and nobody really cares about it except for me. So that's basically gonna be the rule. We're gonna see how it's gonna go. At this point I don't feel like there's a lot I really want to buy, so that's a kind of like the background information for this particular episode. And also, if you feel like I could say no to something and I'm like, maybe I will buy it, keep me in check. Let me know. Help me out a little bit. Sometimes it's hard to say no, especially if you're like really excited to review all these things for your channel. So let's start with this. The new limited edition eyeshadow palette by House Labs. It's called Love for Sale. It looks like a pretty neutral palette, pretty standard neutral tones. And then we have some kind of berry shades and some green shades. I'm not really interested in House Labs. This color story doesn't look very interesting, special, revolutionary. It all looks kind of basic. And this is definitely something I don't need, don't want. And this is not a brand I'm into. So I'm gonna be skipping on that. Urban Decay revealed the new Marvel Studios Eternals collection. So this is gonna be a limited edition collection based on the new movie, The Eternals. I definitely want to go see that movie. I think the trailer looks so cool and I'm definitely a bit of a Marvel fan. I go to a lot of the Marvel movies, but I don't have a lot of faith in Urban Decay that they can do good collaborations. I mean, just thinking back at the Game of Thrones, I loved Game of Thrones, but that was all just so bulky and boring, and I feel like this is gonna be the same thing. I almost feel like they don't expect you to actually use the makeup when you buy a collection like this. It's like it's more about the experience, the packaging, but not really about the quality or the color story. So I feel like they're just throwing some random shades, some random things together, and then calling that a collection and spending a lot more time on the packaging. But the packaging is so bulky, I don't have time. I don't have a space to actually keep that. I don't have a space to put that, so I'm gonna skip on this. If they would have done a collaboration with a brand that's a bit more interesting to me, where I feel like the quality is a little bit more consistent and better, and I would have more faith in the quality, then maybe I would have been interested. But I just don't care about these limited edition collaboration collections by Urban Decay. I generally don't really care about the brand. I don't know. It's not really my kind of brand right now. They used to be. Then we have a new Wayne Goss palette. This is called the Covetable Tourmaline Luxury. I hope I said it correctly. So this is gonna have 6 shades, like all his other eyeshadow palettes. It's gonna be available already at Beautylish. I don't know how much it is. Doesn't say the price here. We also have some, are those eye pencils? Those are eye pencils. I think it looks pretty nice. It looks quite nice, especially the swatches. I feel like the swatches look a little bit deeper and more intriguing than the actual photo of the palette. I think this is one of the most interesting releases he has done. The other ones I didn't really care for. This one I still don't really care for, but it's a bit more interesting for sure. I quite like it, but this is a thing I can easily skip on. It's gonna be too expensive for me. I don't feel like it's gonna add enough to my collection. And it's not really a brand that I'm so interested in. I feel like it's not really for me. It's not really my makeup style and aesthetic and what I look for in brands. It's a very luxury vibe, and sometimes I like that, for sure. Sometimes I can appreciate that, but I think it's a bit too basic maybe for me. Then BH Cosmetics is collaborating with Doja Cat, I don't know. I do know some of her music actually, but that's mostly the fault of TikTok. I think if I didn't have TikTok, I wouldn't have heard of her. So we have a Mega Palette 36 color eyeshadow palette for $36. A mini shadow quad in 3 different colorways for $14. Powder blush trios for $16. Prism loose powder highlighter $14. And a mascara, eyeliner, brush set, hand mirror, lip balm. There's a lot in this collection. I don't think any of this looks really interesting. It looks a bit cheapy to me. It looks a bit thrown together. I don't really like how those quads look because I feel like the pans are too small for the packaging. Those trios look kind of nice, but I definitely don't need any blush. And probably I'm gonna buy some more blush, so then at least I should buy things that I don't know if I'm gonna love or what it's all about. So that's not something I'm gonna buy. The eyeshadow palette just looks a bit too big, and I don't feel like there's really a color story here. Also, I watched a video by Angelica, and she said that the mattes were nice, but the shimmers weren't that interesting, and it wasn't her favorite palette, so I'm gonna skip on that. If I buy a big palette, I need to know. I need to be sure that I'm gonna love all the shades. I usually don't get such big palettes, so I'm gonna be skipping on this. With these collaborations, I also always kind of wonder how much effort and how much time and how much creativity have these famous stars actually put in this eyeshadow palette. Did they really choose all these shades, or did someone do that for them and they just wanted to put their name on something and make some money? I'm wondering, do they really love makeup? You don't really see them talking about it a lot. You don't really see them posting about it a lot. I don't know how I feel about these collaborations. I like collaborations more when you know that the collaborator was so happy that they got the chance to do this. So I don't know about this one. I don't really care about it. Then this Sunsculpt Liquid Bronzer by She Glam Official. This is the Shein makeup brand. And I thought this looked pretty interesting. I'm not gonna buy it. And the shades are really interesting as well. A bit of an interesting shade range. But I guess if I would buy anything, then it would be Warm Honey. But wouldn't that be a bit too warm? I don't know. I thought it just looked pretty interesting, but I'm not gonna buy it. I believe it's gonna be $5. I'm not really into these makeup brands from those really, really cheap clothing shops, web shops. In the past, I have bought some Primark makeup, and I didn't think it was bad, but in the end, I don't really care about this type of makeup that much. But I do feel like they did something right with this picture, with the promo shots. It looks really cool. Then we have a new Orchid collection by ColourPop. When they showed the first photos of this, it looked very, very similar to the Wine and Only. I was like, why are they releasing another Wine and Only and just calling it different? But when I saw, when we saw some more clear pictures, better quality pictures, it became clear that it was more purple. And at first I was like, I definitely don't need this. Now I'm like, I'm slightly interested. It looks pretty nice, but it's definitely not something that I need. And it's definitely not something that I need right now. So this is gonna be one that's gonna be in the back of my mind. Maybe one time I will do an order at Colourpop if they have like free shipping or they have like 30% off or 25% off palettes. I will keep this in the back of my mind because there's something interesting about this color story, and these are definitely colors that I like to wear. I think it's a beautiful shade of purple and I really like the packaging. So this is one I might pick up at some point if it's a better moment for me to actually buy that. Glossier has revealed the monochromatic palettes. These are palettes with three different shades for $22. You can refill them for $18 and they are already available. This is the makeup. This is the kind of makeup that I just really don't care about. Three pans, that doesn't inspire me. And they are so, so muted, so light. There's nothing interesting or inspiring for me about these. And this doesn't give me the feels like I want to put that on my eyes. Maybe I can combine it like this. Maybe I can wear it like this. It just looks really, really basic, and Glossier is just not a brand that's really for me, I think. It's just a bit too basic. I'm not gonna buy a three pan like this, especially if all the shades in the three pan look kind of similar. I guess, yeah, that's kind of all I have to say about that. Then Glowish is coming out with some new glowy setting powders that you can use as kind of like a powder foundation as well. And then they also have new blushes. I'm not really looking for a powder, not really looking for a powder foundation. So I'm not going to be buying that. Although I think it's pretty interesting. The blushes, of course, I was a bit intrigued by. I already talked about them a bit last week. I am a bit intrigued by, but I feel like there's not the perfect shade for me. And I just think it would be good if I didn't buy as many blushes. I have bought so many blushes this year, and I think it's time to kind of take a minute, reflect, and just use the things that I have a little bit more before I buy new things. So I'm kind of gonna put myself on a blush low buy, no buy for a bit. I haven't really thought up the official rules about that, but I guess it's the same as everything else. If I can say no, I'm gonna say no. And this is not gonna be something, this was never gonna be something where I was gonna be the first one to review it. And I wasn't gonna combine it with that powder. So then it's already just a little part of the launch. So I was like, I'm not gonna be the right person to do this review probably. So I'm just gonna skip on it for now. It's gonna be in the back of my mind, but I don't think that any of these shades is perfect. So I'd rather wait for them to release another shade probably, and then I might buy it. It's just, there are so many beautiful blush formulas and blushes on the market, and I have so many beautiful blushes. So I kind of at some point have to say no to blushes that interest me. So That's what I'm trying to do. Jaclyn Hill is once again collabing with Morphe. It's kind of a surprise, but also kind of not. It's something we all expected, but still feels kind of weird because she has her own brand. This is going to be a 12 pan palette for $18. It's already available. This is definitely the most boring looking collab that she has done, I feel, with Morphe. I don't think this is a very interesting palette. I feel like too many of the shades look too similar, but it's a 12 pan. So how did you manage to make it look so similar? I feel like there's not a lot of variation here, and it doesn't interest me at all. Her other collabs kind of interested me. They interested me a little bit more, but I still didn't want to buy it because of the history with her and the releases on Morphe and just how shady this brand feels to me. I feel like it's a bit shady and that it's not the best quality. So this is the one I thought was the most uninteresting. It feels uninspired. It feels like she just quickly threw something together. I mean, why would we buy this? This is like the most basic shades that were already in all her releases before and in all the other Morphe palettes. It doesn't add anything. Why would you make this if it doesn't add anything? It just feels like, okay, I have to do this. Let's just do this. Let's just do this and this and this and this. Okay. Like, they haven't even thought about it for more than an hour. It almost feels like that. It just feels a bit like a lazy release and like she didn't really feel like doing this collab. Probably she will make some money with it and probably people are still gonna buy it. I'm not going to. Then MAC is planning to collab with Whitney Houston's Estate. This is not really something I can say a lot about just yet. It's just a little bit, it's just the same for me as with the Prince collab. I feel it's a bit odd. It feels a bit weird to collab with people who are no longer alive. Even if it was her dream, they say it was her dream to do this, you don't even know what she would have wanted to do. And she won't even know that she got to do it. And then why didn't they do it while they were alive? I have mixed feelings about this. I don't think I'm likely going to pick anything up from this. Then we have the MAC Cosmetics and Rosalia Haute Couture collection. We have some lipsticks, a retro matte liquid lip colors, nail adornments, nail lacquers. Lacquer? Do you say it? Lacqué? That's a word, I don't know. Then we have an Extra Dimension Skin Finish palette for $60. An eyeshadow palette for $50. Available October 1st, so it's already available. And it's available October 4th in stores. So I think some parts of this collection look pretty cute. The thing that I would be most interested in would be that Extra Dimension palette. But I don't think that I really need these shades. It's not terrible. It doesn't look terrible. I guess those lip shades are quite nice. I don't hate it, but I don't love it. I'm slightly interested in the Extra Dimension skin finishes, but I don't think this palette is gonna be for me. Tower 28 Beauty is coming out with the Sunny Days SPF 30 tinted sunscreen. I think this is slightly interesting because the fact that it's tinted does mean that you don't get like a white cast. This is gonna be available October 12th. I think this is slightly interesting, but I kind of found my way to wear my SPF without it looking like I have a white cast. I kind of mix it in with a bronzing drop. I don't fully know how I feel about this, but it is very likely that there's gonna be some ingredient in this that my skin doesn't like. I have very sensitive skin and I don't really know how I feel about using a tinted product like this. This is one that I'm just interested to know more. I'm interested to see a video, to watch a video, to see what other people think. But the chances of me actually buying this are small. But I'm just slightly interested and I want to know what this is about. Or if this is nice or what people think. If this is going to be something that is actually going to protect your skin. If this is something that's not going to protect my skin. If it's like two full coverage if you really use enough, then I'm probably not gonna be picking this up for sure. So there's like a 99% chance that I'm not gonna be buying that. Glam Light is coming out, has come out with a Happy Hour collection. This one is inspired by different types of alcohol. It's already available. I've already seen some videos about it. You may know that Glam Light is a brand that I'm pretty interested in. I quite like their eyeshadows. I quite like their products. I do have two palettes by them. I recently got into them and I'm kind of eyeing the brand. So let's chat about these palettes. The neutral palette, the green palette, and the purple palette are the ones that interest me. I think the green palette looks really nice. It doesn't look like you have to do a very warm green olive-y look. I feel like you have some other options there as well that make it interesting for me. I don't really love warm greens, but I do see some options here. I do think it's a nice looking palette. The neutral palette, I think I will be most likely to pick up. The purple palette, first I was like, is it too similar to the Red Velvet Cupcake? But this one is definitely a lot more blue purple. Those are not the shades that I use the most, but I do really like the look of this palette. So I didn't pick this up right away because I don't really feel like paying for the shipping and the taxes and the duties and everything and waiting for a month for it to come to me, because I'm in the Netherlands and buying things from the States can be very, very expensive, and shipping from Glamlight is just too expensive, and I'm not gonna be the first to review it anyway then. So I'm just waiting for it to come to a Dutch web shop, and when it's there I will probably pick some things up from this collection. I will decide then, and I think I might pick up the neutral one and then maybe the green one. I'm just gonna see how I feel in a month. And probably then I will have watched some more videos. Glamlight is just a brand that I pick up for myself because I like it. But when I have it in my hands, it's been like over and done and talked about. And everybody has made up their mind about it already. So nobody really wants to see, I feel, my videos on it. But I'm just really interested in the brand. So I have to kind of keep that in mind. I'm not in a hurry. I'm just gonna see how I feel when this comes to the Netherlands, when I can order it. Yeah, probably I'm gonna pick up something. We also have some lippies. We also have some highlighters. I don't know how I feel about those. I think the lip swatches look really, really pretty. I might pick up a lip or two. I was slightly interested in the Pina Colada highlighter, but maybe it's a bit too basic and it's more the completionist in me. I'm not really a completionist, but I mean, the fact that something is in a collection that I'm interested in makes me sometimes want to add just that one extra thing. I'm just gonna think about it a little bit more. I'm definitely interested, but I don't have to decide just yet. I just have to wait a little bit and then I have some time to think about it. I don't really want to buy three palettes. I'm probably gonna buy two palettes of this collection. Let me know which of these palettes you are most interested in. We have a new collection by Made by Mitchell. It's a milk palette with 25 pans for £40. And then we have some other things as well. Blending sponge, blush, which I think is a really interesting name. This is already available. I think this is a pretty nice color story, but because of the chaotic background and the bright colors, it didn't feel to me, when I looked at it at first, it didn't feel to me as a different palette than what he has already released. I was like, what's the difference here? It's just hard to see, I feel, with the background. But if I look at it a bit closer, I do think that it's a quite interesting color story. You have some pretty shades here. I quite like it. But I think I like the idea of this palette more than I actually like the palette. When I will actually use it, I think I won't like it as much as just looking at it. For example, that acid green next to that more khaki green, I think looks so cool. But I would never do a look like that. I would never put that on my eyes like that. So I quite like this color story, but I'm not gonna buy this. It's not really a brand that I'm interested in. I don't really want to try any new brands right now because I just can't add that. There are so many videos that I want to film, and I filmed so many videos. I've put up so many videos the past few weeks, and also reviews, and things just keep adding up, and I just need a little bit of time to breathe and to do a bit less reviews. So I'm not gonna add more than I can handle. I'm not gonna add more brands than I can handle. So I'm not gonna be buying that. Makeup by Mario is coming out with the Ultra Sweat Lip Collection. This is a brand that I'm slightly interested in, but it's not that readily available in Europe. They are available on Cult Beauty, I believe, but they just have the basic range, and the first launch was the thing that I wasn't interested in, that I didn't want anything from. So I will probably, when there are more of the newer releases on the Cult Beauty website, I will probably watch some videos and then decide if I want to try anything. So I'm not really gonna be super, super interested in the new releases. I just have to wait and see if I can actually buy it. XX Revolution has revealed a collaboration with the Matrix. It looks pretty futuristic, I guess. I don't really have much of an opinion about this collection. I did watch the Matrix when I was young, but I was a bit too young to really get it. So I never really fully experienced the movies. I know what it's about. I know what's going on. I know about the blue pill and the red pill and things like that. But I never got into them as much as people older than me, I think. I think it's a bit of a random collaboration, but at this point, I feel like every brand is collaborating with everything. So it doesn't really surprise me. I just don't need anything and I don't have any feelings about this. It's just okay looking to me. I'm not really interested. Then we have a new Fenty Beauty Holiday 2021. Glossy Posy Fantasy Foursome. And in this 4-pack of shades, we have the Fenty Glow Fantasy, Hot Chocolate Fantasy, Champ Stamp Fantasy, and a Gloss Balm Cream in Candy Milk. I don't know what this fantasy formula is about. I don't know what it is exactly. But I'm not into the Fenty Gloss Balms. I don't find them very comfortable to wear because there's just too much of a scent in it and it gives me a headache and it gives me a bad taste in my mouth. So I'm not interested in this. Part of me wishes I could wear this, but I just can't. I just can't handle it. Luna Beauty has come out with the Moonspell Volume 2 collection. I was very hopeful when he was teasing this and I was kind of like, if he releases something new, I really want to try it. I really want to try the brand because this is a brand I'm really excited about, but I have never tried anything. I'm just really into the whole vibe of Luna Beauty. So I was like, I want to try this. I think it's going to be good. And if it's good, I want to buy it. But then I saw it and I feel like this is just a bit basic. And it doesn't give me what I would want from them. It's just a bit too bright for me. For me to be a spooky palette. But also, I feel like this color story has been done. I feel like a year ago or so, we were really into this red, purple, neutral color story. I feel like it looks very similar to things that we've seen a lot already. It made me think of the Morphe and Jaclyn Hill Volume 2 Big Palette. It's just a color story that we've seen over and over. It doesn't give me the spooky vibes. I'm sure it's nice quality, but I can't buy this. I know this is not gonna be what I want from the brand. Probably is better if I really have it and do the looks, but I feel like there are some really bright shades here that kind of throw me off, and I feel like some shades look a little bit too similar. I guess in the swatches they don't look that similar, but then when I look at it in the pan they look a bit similar. I guess if you see it in real life it won't have really really repeat shades, but I just don't feel inspired by this palette. It's not what I expected, and I feel like it's a bit too late. This isn't on trend and I feel like we're kind of past this now. So I'm kind of disappointed. I'm a bit disappointed. I'm not gonna be picking this up and I'm just gonna be waiting for the next release. Sometimes I wish that the indie brands that I was really into would release a little bit more. Of course, it's hard for them to do. It's expensive. They're doing everything themselves. I get it, but then if you don't like the release, then sometimes you have to wait a year to really have a chance again to try out the brand. This is the new the VIP Expert Palette Bonjour Paris by Terry. This is now available on Beautylish. This is very basic looking. There's something kind of cute about it, but it's too basic for me. We have a new Too Faced mini palette. This is the Christmas Coffee mini eyeshadow palette for $27. I think these mini palettes are just so boring. Just every one of them looks the same. I'm just so bored. Just stop already. I don't care. We have the Addams Family and Hip Dot collection. I believe this is part two. Is this or is the movie? I don't know if the collaboration or the movie is two, but it says here Addams Family 2 times Hip Dot. So we have the Spells and Hexes pigment palette for $24, a lipstick trio box set. It's available October 5th, so it's already available. This is not something I'm interested in. There's something about spooky releases and spooky vibes that I really like, but I have to stop myself and not buy those things because I only like that in October, and then when it has passed, I don't really feel like using those things anymore. This is just something that's very specific to this time of year, and I know I won't really be reaching for it. And then I will maybe use it once and maybe feel guilty about it after 6 months and then use it again one time. But those types of palettes with this kind of theme, they can't really be part of my collection, I feel, throughout the whole year. So I don't really care about this color story, but that's another reason that I'm not gonna be picking this up. Then ColourPop is coming out with a new Mega Palette and Eye Primer. So it's a Play Duo eyeshadow palette with 30 matte and shimmery shades and a party proof eye primer in translucent, caramel and deep. So when I first saw this palette, I was slightly interested for like 5 minutes, and then I realized that if you just take away the four interesting colorful shades, the teal, the purple and a pink and maybe the blue, if you would take that away, then it's just the same as all their other big palettes. So I don't need this. I feel like this is how ColourPop gets you. They release a big palette and 80% of it is just the basic shades, but then they throw in a few of the really interesting ones that make the whole palette look more interesting, and then you're like, ooh, do I want to get that? So I feel like they're kind of fooling us with this, and I really don't need this. I'd rather just buy a smaller palette with some teals. But then once again, I'm like, do I really need more teals? So I don't need... I like it. There's something about it that I like, but I don't need it. There's something cute about it, but I don't need it. Then the eye primer. Eye primers usually don't really work on me because I have very oily eyelids. I've talked about this before, but part of me kind of wants to know if this is good, because I would like to have an eye primer, find an eye primer that I can recommend to you guys, that I can recommend to people who also have really oily eyelids. Right now I'm using one that's only available in the Netherlands, so I just kind of want to find something else as well, just because I'm on YouTube and because I want to be able to tell you what you can use. This is also one that's like gonna be saved in the back of my mind, and then if I make a ColourPop order, if there's sale or something, I might pick this up. Essence has come out with the Coffee to Glow collection. Everything is with a coffee scent, and this is gonna be a lot of kind of skincare things, and then we also have a highlighter and an eyeshadow palette. So this collection isn't really makeup heavy. If it had more makeup, I maybe would have been interested to try this for my channel, but I really don't feel like using a coffee body scrub and reviewing a coffee lip scrub. It's just a bit too much a collection with those little silly little things, extras that you don't really care about, but they just kind of fill up the collection with that. That's how it feels for me, and so I'm not really interested. I am always kind of on the lookout for new limited edition Essence and Catrice. So if this would have been more with makeup, with some different makeup items, I maybe would have checked it out. Kylie Cosmetics has revealed their Halloween collection. This is the A Nightmare on Elm Street collection. The eyeshadow palette is $30. We also have some lip trios. We have some lashes and lip and cheek jelly stain. So once again, this is going to be a Halloween release, I think. It's a smart choice, but as I told you, I don't really want to buy anything Halloween themed. I think the color story looks a bit too basic, and the palette just looks a bit uninteresting to me. In the past, I've been slightly interested in Kylie's palettes because there's always been something about them that made them look so good. But I don't feel like this palette really has that. We just have some neutrals with some reds. It doesn't really inspire me, so there's not even a part of me that's slightly interested in this. I'm definitely not going to be buying that. BH Cosmetics is coming out with the Poison Shock Colorful Collection. which is called Poison Shock. 9 color shadow palettes, $15 each. We have 6 different shades. We have purple, pink. We have some different monochromatic palettes. We also have a highlighter palette and some liquid eyeshadow. Also some lip gloss. I feel like they're kind of releasing things that aren't really necessary. Maybe they're kind of trying to repeat the success of the Sweet Shop palette, because they were also monochromatic and they were really popular. This just feels like an unnecessary release to me. It doesn't feel very interesting. Doesn't feel like anything new or anything that I need. Probably it's good quality, but I just feel like I'm so done with all these monochromatic palettes. I'm just so done with all these monochromatic palettes. Why do they keep pushing that on us? I just want to see some color stories. I just don't feel like this adds a lot to the BH Cosmetics range. Be Perfect Cosmetics is releasing a collaboration with Ellie Kelly. It's a Born Ready collection with a Born Ready palette. I think this all looks a bit too neutral, too simple, too basic for me. But a part of me kind of wants to try Be Perfect. So at some point I might try this brand, but I just think that this is not interesting enough for me. It's just a very classic glam. BH Cosmetics has launched the Birdstone collection. This one is the Opal palette for October. They are releasing a lot of stuff. We're talking about a lot of BH Cosmetics in this episode. So this is kind of like an iridescent pastel-y palette. I'm not really interested in this range, and this color story also doesn't pull me in. Beauty Bay is releasing a collaboration with Jade Thirlwall, and this is going to be available Monday 11th October. This has astrological vibes, apparently. I don't know who Jade is. I looked her up and apparently she has a lot of followers, but I don't know who she is. I think it looks pretty cute, but it's a big palette with a lot of shades, and I don't think I need this right now. And I don't really feel like trying the Beauty Bay brand right now. There's something about this that kind of pulls me in, that I kind of like. I like this combination of neutrals with pops of color, kind of like this half-half 50-50 split of neutrals and colors. So there's something about this that I am interested in. But yeah, I'm not going to be buying this one. We have another palette by Beauty Bay as well. This is the... I don't know what this palette is called. What is this palette? Okay, I will put it on the screen. But this is a kind of neutral teal, purple, bluish palette. It's a very nice color story, I think. When I first saw this, I thought it looked very, very interesting. But I just don't have room in my life and in my collection right now to be trying this one. So I'm gonna skip on it, even though a part of me really, really loves this. Let me just see if I can find the name of this real quickly. It's called The Age of Opulence. Okay, interesting name. So yeah, I really like it, but I'm just a bit unsure if I'm gonna like the Beauty Bay formula, if I think it's gonna be worth it. I also don't really feel like making a Beauty Bay order just for one palette, but then I also don't wanna buy more things. This is just a brand that I might try somewhere in the future, but I'm not interested enough. I'm not gonna be buying that. So last week, just right after I filmed my episode, this was revealed, the Adept Cosmetics Amunet palette. We have a lighter version and a deeper version. I put a picture on the screen in my video and I said I was slightly interested. I think this is a very pretty looking palette. The one I like the most is a light one. I think it's a very fall appropriate color story. Some beautiful shimmers. I think the swatches look amazing. But this is something that I can say no to right now. It's something that I can decide not to buy right now, because once again, I'm not gonna be the first to review this anyway. And these are not shades that are like so revolutionary in my collection. It's a brand that I haven't reviewed yet. It's a brand that I haven't tried yet. I definitely want to try it in the future, but this is not the right time. So I'm going to be skipping on it for now. Maybe if I see very, very good reviews, I might try to buy this when it restocks or when there's another pre-order. But part of me is just like, I don't need this. I don't actually need this. So maybe I'd better just skip on it completely. Then Nabla Cosmetics has come out with the Regeneration Uplifting Creamy Concealer. Oh, it's gonna be available October 13th. So it's not available yet, but they have revealed it. I was very hopeful. I was so hopeful when they said that they were gonna come out with something new, but I don't need a concealer, I don't want a concealer. I was kind of hoping for another side by side nude style eyeshadow palette, maybe. I was hoping for something, maybe blushes, more highlighter shades. In my mind, when my favorite brands say that they are releasing something new, I'm thinking of all the things that it could be and that I would want and what I would want my perfect release to be. I kind of dream about what it could be, and then when it's a concealer, it's like, okay, thanks for saving me some money, but I was hoping for something interesting. But now Liza Brand, if they will release something very interesting, an interesting new collection with eyeshadows, cheek products, things like that, that's a brand that I'm not gonna say no to. So that's kind of like the exception on the low buy or no buy, whatever I'm doing right now. So yeah, I just wanted to talk about this because I was slightly sad, but I hope it's gonna be nice. I hope people are gonna like it. I'm just not gonna try it. And then Glaminatrix Cosmetics, they showed this mock-up of their Silent Night palette. I think it looks really pretty, really cool. I think it's gonna be a bit more interesting because of a multi-chrome and their shimmery shades. I want to try more Glaminatrix. They are just a brand. I love how their swatches look and I love the shades that I bought. I think it's a really interesting brand and everything they do just looks so beautiful. This is a palette that I would want. Part of me wants, but once again, when am I, after Christmas is over, after New Year's is over, am I still gonna be using this palette? Am I just gonna be using this palette like 2 times every year because it's Christmas themed? I'm not sure. A part of me wants this, but am I gonna be tired of this once it's no longer the holidays? Am I still gonna be using this? So this is what I'm kind of thinking about, but I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna be picking this up in the end. Kiko has come out with the Precious Rituals collection. I've already made a video about this. I've already done a first impression. Once again, when I saw a post on this, I ran to the store. I ran back, filmed the video, and edited and uploaded it. I always try to be really fast with my Kiko reviews. So this is a very pretty collection once again with some interesting products. They have some wooden packaging for the cheek products and the eyeshadow palettes, which is really, really pretty. I bought an eyeshadow palette, highlighter, bronzer, blush duo, and lipstick. I loved everything. The eyeshadow palette, once again, is a little bit on the subtle side for me. So that one isn't like my perfect eyeshadow palette, but the rest that I tried, I really liked. I will link the video down below. Just check it out. You can see everything there, but you know that I'm gonna buy the new Kiko. Kiko is a brand that I really love to review on my channel. They also came out with some new Glamour Multi-Finish palettes. There are 6 palettes in different color stories. I also saw this in the store, but I was so focused on the limited edition that I didn't take a lot of time to look at this. I didn't have a lot of time, but I swatched a shimmer. I thought it looked very pretty. These are palettes that I might check out a little bit better in store if I have time, but I don't feel like this is something that is necessary for me to pick up now, to review now, and to try now. It's not like these colors are colors that I really don't have yet, so I just want to go in store at some point and kind of swatch it and see what I think of the colors and quality. I might pick something up if I feel like the textures are really, really nice. So that's kind of like a maybe in the future, but not right now, especially because I just bought more Kiko. And maybe I shouldn't overflow my collection with Kiko and just buy all the Kiko. That's also not what I'm planning to do. Then Natasha Denona revealed 2 mini eyeshadow palettes. Both are 3 pens, and we have one that's with shade from the Glam palette and one from the Biba palette. I just really don't care about this. I won't buy it if I see it. 3 shades, it's just not enough. And I don't really love Natasha Denona's formula. And probably it's still gonna be kind of expensive, too expensive for me. But that doesn't really matter even. I just don't really care about these shades. I have the Natasha Mini Glam, and that's enough for me. And that's actually gonna be everything for the new releases. That's everything we had to chat about. So thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments what you think about these new releases. Is there anything you're gonna pick up? Did you agree with me or maybe not? Don't forget to like this video if you liked it. And don't forget to subscribe. And then I'll see you in my next one. Bye bye.